Well, it's a brand new week. So get ready, because we are ready for you. It's going to be, this is the third week in the month of September. I'm looking forward to something really, really great, really wonderful, very productive for you this week.
You know, it really feels good to start your Monday with us. Indeed, we're starting it with you. A lot of people just doing the school run right now, just waking up. We're hoping that we're going to boost your morning in the right way.
And I always remember that a working day is never going to be perfect. However, you got to make that money, right? So stick around with us for the next 3 hours or so. And then you'll probably learn a thing or two about some motivation, what you need to do.
Yeah, of course. Like Mondays are all about the motivation. It's Wake Up Nigeria, so wake up, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to your favorite breakfast show. My name is Titi Layo Oyinsan.
And I'm Yomi Okwe. Well, we're just starting out. But, you know, how was your weekend?
Amazing. So many things happened this weekend. When it comes to the kids, getting them ready for school this week. Also, there was a birthday party where the one of my girls won a dancing competition, so I was a bit excited about that.
And a birthday party.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was interesting, but we need to tell people that they can stream with us. Please stream with us at tvcentertainment.tv and, of course, on Facebook at TVC Connect.
Yeah, you can also send in your comments on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Use the hashtag WakeUpNigeria on TVC.
Yes, so we have some great news, though. Just make sure you wait.
We're going to be talking about that very shortly.
So don't forget to download the mobile app so you can hear what we're talking about. Android or iOS stores, both of them have it. Just download the app to your mobile devices, and anywhere you are, you'll be able to see us.
Okay, so let's give you a lowdown on what's about to go down.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I like that. Lowdown on what's about to go down.
Yeah.
On the show today. to start things off with the latest development in the world of tech, that's what's going to be happening.
Yes.
We talked about the iPhone 11 last week.
Mm-hmm. So many things, so many different innovations in tech
this period.
And we'll be telling you what's what very, very soon.
Then we're going to have a performance from, this is the first musical performance. It's going to be from a Bottles Entertainment artist, L.A. Crown. And then Los Angeles-based pop and R&B artist Devin Kelly is also going to be performing today. Looking forward to that one.
They don't know what they talking about. You still a king, you a goddess. Just
for Monday motivation this morning, Coach Triple A is going to be giving us tips on how to start a winning day. So you start off the day and you know it's going to be about winning.
You know you're going to win.
Yes, sir.
And on auto segment, Yomi Bosude will be telling us what to do, what not to do when driving in the rain.
Yes, sir.
I mean, you see all sorts of things on the express. And a lot of confusion as well. So yeah, he's going to be talking to us.
Some people just don't know the rules.
Yeah.
And on SME this week, we'll be having Alex Efeini. Now, it says, so he's the CEO of Lingam Design, an interior design firm based in Lagos. And you are going to have an interesting time hearing from this gentleman. All right.
A new week has started.
Yes, sir.
New week.
And with it, a new baby.
Yes, sir. Congratulations, MM.
Yeah.
MM has had her baby. Yes, I brought out my game day voice for this one.
Oh, yeah. So congratulations to MM. It's very exciting.
Two daughters now.
Oh, two daughters.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Two daughters in 2 years.
Wow, no. Really?
I like it. It's a nice thing, you know.
Mike and MM are actually quite close. You know, they're very good friends in the office. And we're expecting him to come with maybe pink balloons into the office this morning or something.
Apparently not.
No apples now. So the deal is,
what?
We either have to change the show or we change the name.
Why?
2 years, Wake Up Nigeria.
Okay.
If the show should enter 3 years now, we don't know.
Hey,
okay. Big shout out to him, congrats.
You know, it'd be nice if it's a yearly thing. Maybe someone else has a baby next year.
Maybe you. Is there something you're trying to tell us?
Yes. Yeah,
I'm not saying anything. I'm talking of you.
Really?
I mean, I've done my three and I'm retired.
What are you guys feeling like?
Titi has done her two. Yeah. Has done her two.
So, Mary,
it might be him. You never know what he's been up to all this weekend.
If it be me.
If it be you.
That's how it is.
But it is great news.
Yeah, it is.
And we all waited for this baby with her. We watched her glam and slay her way through that pregnancy like a trooper, you know?
Yeah.
At a point, she stopped wearing the heels. You know,
no, but she waited to the last minute.
Yes, she did.
So she would carry the heels. Then when she has to, she puts them on. Then puts them up.
Mm-hmm. But she's amazing. And congratulations to her and her
family. Congratulations,
sweetie. And I know that all the messages are going to be coming in now. Use our hashtag #WakeUpNigeria on TVC.
That's
send in
right.
your messages.
Yeah, I already saw there was a post on our Instagram and also on our Twitter.
Yeah. And gosh, people, I love the outfits.
Lots of people have been commenting. Mm. You know, congratulating Emma. But if you're just hearing, if this is your first time appearing, send a congratulations.
Two other members of staff also had children yesterday, like new babies, a boy and a girl.
Boy and a girl.
So now three children born on September 15th.
Children. We should have a TVC children's party.
We should. We should.
I'm sure that there will probably be more than 100.
I'm
not kidding. I'm not kidding. I mean,
there are a lot of
three
babies
in 1 weekend. Not just 1 weekend, one day.
It does show that there are a lot, you know, it's about being fruitful, bountiful. But then someone else commented that, man, what was it that happened 9 months ago today? Some people were really, really busy.
That's January 15th.
I'm just saying.
Okay, January.
February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September.
December
15th. Apparently, Christmas was in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so December 15th. To September 15th. So we'll be very careful. I think what management has to do is no holidays this Christmas, just so as to make sure things remain the same by next September.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mary. Why, Mary?
I'm not there. Well, we know that it's about time for us to head for the news update.
And of course, Ibrahim, how's it going?
It's going fine. It's a really good news for TVC staff yesterday. Segun, Tosin and MM Okoche. You know, it's really, really interesting story to hear yesterday. Let's go straight to the news. Following the backlash against xenophobic attacks in South Africa, President Cyril Ramaphosa has sent out special envoys to deliver messages of solidarity to several heads of state and government across the continent. The team will visit Nigeria, Niger, Ghana, Senegal, Tanzania, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Zambia. The special envoy comprises of former minister in the presidency, Mr. Jeff Radebe, Ambassador Kingsley Mbalu, and Dr. Hulu Mbatha. They are expected to reassure fellow African countries that South Africa is committed to the ideals of Pan-African unity and to the rule of law. The envoy will also brief governments on steps being taken to end the attacks and bring perpetrators to book. And the wife of a pastor with the Evangelical Church winning all in Kaduna State has been kidnapped. Esther Katung was abducted in Benin Gwari local government area of the state. The Christian Association of Nigeria says that the abductors are demanding 5 million naira's ransom. Her husband escaped with injuries and is receiving treatment in hospital. And in Taraba State, residents and the police are divided over the identity of 30 gunmen who attempted to kidnap a traditional ruler, Haniel Bamti. Our correspondent Olabi Adunusi compiled this report.
The aftermath of an attempt to kidnap or kill the traditional ruler of the Yadang people is his house bullet-ridden from sporadic fire. He survived it thanks to an alarm raised by neighbors.
In the morning, while I was awake, I heard strange voices at the back of my house. They spoke in a language that I can identify. Saying that this is the house. So I was alert and I left what I was doing at that point in time. Already the security men, my guards were already alert.
Police authorities in the state profiled the attackers as cattle rustlers, but residents disagree.
They started shooting from my house. They came personally, they started pushing my gate. And the next thing, I hear shooting. Bah, 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 from my house. Then we lay down, we did not go anywhere. The next thing is to other area. They spare to other area.
I just heard a sound, gun sound in my house around that kind 1:40 something or 1:30. So I shout, I even run to one side.
It was a quite pathetic situation. We knew that definitely there is security challenges, but this one, it was a planned work by hoodlums to ensure that either the hot kidnap or they killed His Royal Highness.
The chief guard to the traditional ruler sustained gunshot wounds during the attack.
What I know is that I was lying as if I was dreaming. I woke up and saw a figure resembling a person on the fence. I immediately woke up my colleague. He blew a whistle and people from neighborhood also woke up. The attacker shot sporadically and I honestly cannot tell the number of bullets they used.
Kidnappings are on the rise in Taraba State, with its perpetrators often targeting highly placed people in society. In spite of extant laws prescribing death penalty for kidnappers.
Now, 30 kidnap victims have been freed in Katsina State following a swap deal between suspected bandits and the state government. They were brought to the government house by one of the bandits who disclosed they were held at Damsadal Forest in Zamfara State. They were received by Governor Aminu Messari and he pledges to persuade the bandits to release more victims. He says they will be taken to hospital for medical checkup before they are reunited with their families. A national leader of the All Progressives Congress, Bola Tinubu, has congratulated Governor Dapo Abiodun on his victory at the tribunal. Bola Tinubu says the judgment further demonstrates that Governor Abiodun's election was indeed a true reflection of the wishes of the people. The national leader believes the victory was well-deserved due to the governor's experience, qualification and peaceful campaign. He encouraged him to extend a hand of fellowship to all the candidates in the election and rededicate himself to reuniting the people. And that's it on the news update for this hour. We'll have to take this break and sport is next.
Looks like we're starting with, like Batman.
Ever played that? No? No?
I did, but just very briefly, way back, some long time ago. So we have different stories in the papers.
Yeah.
And starting with the punch.
It says here, xenophobia, federal government to evacuate 319 from South Africa Tuesday. Ramaphosa sends 3 envoys to Buhari and others. It also says here at the top on the $9.6 billion judgment, probe intensive, borderless, says Malami. Show arrest seeks bail in fresh court application. Page 44 has more on that. Quoted insurance firms seek 142.13 billion naira capital raise. External reserves lowest in 6 months at $42.84 billion. I went through 9 pre-election court cases, says Abiodun. Fish out Foye killer, killer cops, Fayemi tells CP. NLNG seeks $10 billion loan for Train 7. And finally, drunk policeman stabs 9 persons at Ondo nightclub. Goodness me. Goodness me. 9 people? Goodness. All right, that's what we have on the cover of The Punch.
Yeah, let's check out The Vanguard this Monday, September 16. Xenophobia. Ramaphosa sends envoys to Nigeria, 6 other countries. Aftermath of jeers, boos from Mugabe's burial. And Ramaphosa in church blasts perpetrators of attacks. Sue South Africa's government now. Balaji Akinyemi urges the federal government. All that's, you know, you can find on page 5 of The Guardian, on The Vanguard. And Nigeria failed my husband, says wife of murdered Ondo maths professor. Oh, that's a sad one. And why Jonathan refused to sack 3 northern governors over Boko Haram, says former Minister of Justice, Aduke. And Catholic bishops flay Buhari over ministerial appointments. Atiku versus Buhari, PDP governors back party's decision to approach Supreme Court. And mixed reactions trail Akintoye's acceptance as Yoruba leader. And that's what we have at the cover of The Vanguard.
We have The Nation newspaper up next, and it says here, South Africa's envoy heads for Nigeria on peace mission. 320 Nigerians back tomorrow. Akinyemi to federal government, go to world court. No sacred cows in $9.6 billion judgment probe. AGF promises tough action. Meanwhile, PDP governors okay appeal. Tribunal verdict wrong, it says. More on page 12. NSE issues alert on 51 deficient firms. Foye killings, fish out culprits, it says. Page 12 has more on that. Why tribunal didn't rule on Atiku's citizenship? Such task not for panel. Page 29 has more on that. Then finally, Oyo to get 20 years growth plan. Makinde raises the bar. That's what we have on the cover of The Nation.
Yeah, let's check out the Nigerian Tribune. A $9.6 billion P&ID judgment. Nigeria to reopen case on basis of fraud, says Chief Justice Malami there. Minister of Justice Malami. And says fraudulent collaborators won't rip off Nigeria. And down here, some other stories. Police sergeant stabs 9 at nightclub in Ondo. And 13-year-old gang raped by 2 people gives birth in Lagos. That's a sad one there, page 30. And police confirm killing of 3 in Akwa Ibom cult clash. Pressured Ramaphosa sends envoys to Nigeria, 7 other countries. Nigeria should take South Africa to ICC, says Balaji Akinyemi. And up here, your appointments against spirit of total integration, Catholic bishops tell Buhari. Makinde Adelabu, no fate today as tribunal delivers judgment. I survived 9 litigations before my victory at tribunal, says Abiodun. And finally, bandits release additional 40 kidnapped victims in Katsina. That's what we have on the cover of the Nigerian Tribune.
We have the Daily Sun here. And the Daily Sun has this headline, $9.6 billion debt saga. Nigeria fights back. Suspects fraud in gas deal. Probe extends overseas. PNID ghost company with no office anywhere. Findings reveal. Goodness me. I had to giggle at that one. It says, presidential poll, tribunal's verdict can't stand, PDP governors say. Mind your utterances, Kalu tells politicians. New power investors jostle to replace Genco's discos as contract ends December 31st. And on xenophobia, Akinyemi asked federal government to drag South Africa before the ICJ. Ramaphosa sends envoys to African countries. And we'll wrap it up with this one. Senators source loans to prosecute election cases. Wow. That's what we have on the Daily Sun.
Yeah, let's check out The Guardian as the final paper for this hour. And federal government to make 2 trillion naira in 2020 from increase in VAT. Wow. Experts task government on remittances and transparency, seek exemptions for foods, education, primary health care. I think that's a good angle. Mm. And those behind PNID contract award unpatriotic, says Malami. And yellow fever kills 23, infects 169 in Bauchi, and also spreads yellow fever. Wow, that's a story you'd find on page 4. And reps to seek public sector reforms, passage of transition bill. And why Ohanaeze Ndigbo will not congratulate Buhari on tribunal's victory. Pressure on Buhari to sue South Africa over attacks. Akinyemi wants case at ICJ. Anyoku urges caution, seeks compensation. And we're weighing options, won't rule out anything now, says government. That's what we have on the cover of The Guardian. I like this photograph on the cover of The Guardian of the president.
Okay.
With Ogun State Governor, Prince Dakwa Abiodun. It's always nice to fly on that, you know, jet.
The,
that the presidential jet, looking very...
That's a picture that's going to probably go up on his wall.
Yeah, you know, just let's give them that handshake.
Yeah, yeah, that presidential
handshake. That's presidential handshake.
Okay, we have to go now. You can let go of my hand now. Thank you. Traffic is coming up next.
Good morning and thank you for joining us for the Lagos traffic updates on Wake Up Nigeria. It's time for us to make it easier for you as you step out today and of course tell you what the traffic situation is. Please note that you can always be a part of this segment by sending a message on Facebook, on Instagram or even on Twitter to let us know what your traffic situation is. And perhaps take a traffic selfie. But that is if you're not behind the wheels. And don't forget to use the hashtag Wake Up Nigeria on TVC. Okay, so right now we're going to take a look at what the traffic situation is at Orunsoke to Obalende. Yeah, so that's what we're going to check out now. From what I can see here, either way is not so good, okay? If you choose to pass the Third Mainland Bridge, the traffic starts at about the Unilag area. That's where it's, the gridlock actually begins. But before then, though, you could consider the Yaba axis as an option. By using that axis, you save about 10 minutes, okay? And then, of course, you still have to connect to the Third Mainland Bridge. However, if you choose to pass the Third Mainland Bridge, note that from Oro, it's not so bad. But as soon as you get on the bridge, it might seem like, oh, there's no traffic until you get to the Unilag axis. And that's where the traffic gridlock begins. And it's totally bumper to fender all the way till you get off the bridge. We're talking about you spending about an hour, 30 minutes from Orunsoke to Obalende this morning. So if you don't mind spending all that time, then you might want to consider taking the usual routes, you know, but if you want to save about 10 minutes, 10 minutes might not seem much in the morning, I know, but you never can tell. Those 10 minutes can amount to even something better when the traffic eases out. So that's an option for you this morning. Okay, so moving away from the Oworo to Obalende axis, preparing your mind that you will spend about an hour, 30 minutes. Let's take a look at Ilekpo bus stop to Oshodi this morning. From what I can see here, there's traffic. It seems like it's inevitable when you talk about traffic in that axis. However, coming out from Ilekpo is free-flowing at the moment, which is fantastic, especially for those traversing that route. As soon as you are approaching Iyano Ipaja, just expect a bit of traffic. But don't worry, this is out eventually. Getting to Yanokpaja is just the bridge area for now. I cannot promise you it's going to be like that in the next 5 minutes, but as at now, it's pretty like traffic just at the bridge area. But as soon as you traverse the bridge, it's free-flowing, amazingly so, through Iyano, all the way to Iyano Dokpemu. When you get to Iyano Dokpemu, you can see the traffic in front, but don't worry, it's still free-flowing. Getting to Dokpemu Bridge, however, it's there's light traffic here. So you would experience light traffic approaching the bridge and for a few minutes after passing the bridge, okay? After which, of course, it's free-flowing. I can't believe this is the case this morning. But after that, it's free-flowing until you get to Mangoro Access. So when you're getting to Mangoro is where the traffic builds up, and then it becomes bumper to fender traffic, but not for a very long time, because afterwards, just as you're approaching the Ile-Ezik Access, the traffic eases out and is free flowing. Deceptively so, though, because when you get to Ile-Ezik, the traffic begins to build up. It starts off light and then it becomes bumper to fender. It's bumper to fender all the way through Ikeja, along all the way through National. However, as soon as you're about to get on the bridge towards the airport access, the traffic eases out like magic. You know, normally when traffic gridlock is like that, there's light traffic as it's easing out. No, it just immediately eases out. So you wonder, what caused that traffic? Exactly, it's usually the case anyway. And it's free flowing. I mean, amazingly so, free flowing all the way till you get to the arena. That's at Boladi Oshodi, okay? So that's the access you will begin to experience traffic. All right, so I guess that's about it for now. I'm sure the guys have some tweets for me. I'll have them take that while I join them in the kitchen right now.
Well, I think you basically captured everything that that's happening.
Mary is very thorough.
She's extremely thorough with the traffic reports.
Yep.
And so I think we're well covered. But yeah. Mike, you were talking about something.
It's been trending. The trend now is hashtag protect the girls. Mm. It's a number four trend in Nigeria. Mm. But this is as a result of a recent spate of killings in River State. There are about 5-6 girls now who have been killed in about the same style or the same format in different hotels around the state. Mm. So it seems as though a serial killer is on the loose, or a group of people or whatever. Mm. They're doing the same things, hotels and all of that, and young ladies are dying. There's about 5 or 6 of them in River State as a whole. And so it now begs... There's a call for the government to do something. Yeah. It's getting too much. You see the same thing and all of that. Looks very, very funny. Mm. And the cry is that, does it have to be somebody important or somebody big before something is done?
Exactly. Yeah. That's usually what happens. You notice a trend. People are complaining, but nobody's talking. Either someone important or until there's a huge backlash or there's some kind of protest, and then suddenly you then see the police galvanizing and moving into action. But
if you had this kind of set of killings at the same time with the same modus operandi, the MO, by now there should be like a whole task force on it, and sadly there's always so many other distractions happening in the country, killings in the north, and then the xenophobia and all that. So it does feel like this particular story is just coming out now because some of the other stories are dying down. But then let's see if we can give this girls out there some information. There are some things you need to start doing. Fine, nobody's saying you shouldn't live your life. So nobody's saying you shouldn't be free, have fun, go out. But you need to start telling someone where you're going. You need to give people information about your whereabouts, a trusted person at least. Thankfully, with technology now, you can even have a live location tag.
If you
have a best friend or someone you really trust, send a live location tag of where you're going to be or where you're going.
Yeah, so I mean,
and
even
if you can have one for 8 hours.
Even if you're doing coded moves,
code
the moves in a manner that keeps you safe. Mm-hmm. Like, I think one of the things that I found, especially in Nigeria, is because of this, I think this culture of I met a guy, he looks like he's rich, so maybe I'll make some money or survive on the guy for a few months or whatever it is. So you then don't want anybody else to...
to take away that opportunity.
You want to keep it...
Not even just that. Even if it's just a boyfriend. Someone that has just started, making
a relationship with you.
A relationship. Even with there was that story about a year or two ago of the guy that buried his girlfriend under his bed. That it was his own brother that outed him. I don't know if you remember that story. And that was like a legit dating. Right now, we're living in times where you just cannot overcode. You can't.
There was one other one where a lady was invited from the east to Lagos on Facebook.
Yes, that's the in Festac or so.
Yeah, and then she was raped and killed in the hotel. So you hear horror stories like that, and then you know everybody. Then we start talking about it. Yeah. That one, thankfully, those guys were caught because of the CCTV.
Mm. That's exactly what I wanted to point out. We get to a point whereby, first of all, we've never heard that they identified the ladies. So there's no public notice that these are the ladies. We don't even know who they are. First of all, and then number two, like I think it was Alibaba that spoke about this. Getting a statewide or citywide CCTV system would have crimes. By a very large percentage, a very large one. Like, it will cut it down. When people know that they are being watched or that you can track people from where they are going to. Now, from what they say, that this is happening in small hotels or maybe motels, you know, and all over. That's where this kind of things happen, where there's no CCTV. Well, but then, if you had a citywide, maybe by streets, you know who's entering the street, who's going out, who did this person come with, who came in after this person.
Yeah.
You can put a drag in net around where and what you should
And then begin to look at the pattern around the state. Okay, now, they moved here, it looks like they... At least you can have an idea.
That's how we got
it. And then suspicious behavior. There are, you know, we're not living in Minority Report times yet, if you watch that movie.
Yeah, I've seen
To predict that some things are going to happen in a certain area might seem far-fetched, but there are some certain patterns of behavior in certain areas that might give people an insight.
It might not be so far-fetched with AI and stuff.
Yes, you know.
It might not be.
So bottom line is, if you're a young lady or you have a young lady in your vicinity or your neighborhood, give them some advice. Let them tell someone where they're going to. Maybe use a location tag if they have data on their phone. Even if they don't, even these taxi services now, they tell you, please share your trip with someone. Let someone know where you're going.
The taxifiers and things like that.
Mary,
I'm curious to know what you...
She looks upset. She looks very upset at the whole situation.
I'm just... I've heard different, you know, different angles to this story. And at the end of the day, I always tell people, you can't stop people from living their lives. You just need to change mentalities. These things happen all over the world, where somebody wakes up one day, something goes wrong in his brain, and next thing, he just goes after people. And some of them are actually people well-known. In most cases, serial killers are people that are trusted even in the society, in their neighborhood and all. And I find it worrisome that these things take place and so many things are overlooked. Why? Because, oh, these girls died in a hotel. What were they looking for?
That's the average mentality. Or the girls were not that important.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So the average mentality is waiting she to find go hotel. And that reminds me of something that has been trending for some days now. A lady that lost her life. And before that, afterwards, somebody had a similar experience and she shared it. She shared that some people ladies have been dying in hotels lately, that she thinks that the problem is some people are claiming to want to buy items under false pretense.
Okay.
So basically she goes to deliver an item and then the person she's delivering it to says, bring it upstairs.
Or something like that.
And it's a female voice. And she's like, no, come downstairs. I'm at your gate. Bring it. No, come into the hotel lobby. So she goes into the hotel lobby, waits for the woman to come. The woman doesn't come. The woman says, since you've entered the hotel, come upstairs now.
Wow.
She said, no, she's not coming. Because she could even hear a male voice in the background. So some of these girls might not even be out to look for a boy. It might be just pure business.
It's sad. But bottom line, we need more investigation.
Protect yourself. If you're going to be meeting with someone for the first time, and it's not in a public place like a mall, you need extra protection. You know, ensure that you have your
wits about you.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, guys. We have to keep this information out there. Please use our hashtag Wake Up Nigeria on TVC. We'll be back after this break.
Let's take a look at some updates in the tech world. Microsoft has started teasing more information about its upcoming Surface event in New York City next month. The software giant has sent another invite to members of the press. They did that last week with a different image attached to that invite, and it clearly reveals the Surface logo and what looks like the shape of a processor. The invite also reveals that the event will start at 10 a.m. ET on October 2nd. Now, we understand that both Satya Nadella and Microsoft CEO Panos Panay will be in attendance, indicating that there will be some sort of significant news this year. Of course, that's what we love, significant updates to our regularly used softwares and all of that. Okay, all right, now, this one might interest some of you fantasy-seeking techies. Now, fans of sci-fi and fringe tech may already be familiar with the idea of a space elevator, which is pretty much exactly what it sounds like and totally impossible with today's technology. But a pair of scientists think they found an alternative, a moon elevator, and it's slightly less insane technically. Now, the idea of the space elevator first explored in detail by Arthur C. Clarke in his novel, The Fountains of Paradise, is essentially a tower so tall it reaches space. Now, instead of launching ships and materials from the surface of Earth to orbit, you just put them in the elevator of this tower, and when they reach the top, somewhere about 26,000 miles up in geosynchronous orbit, they're already beyond gravity's pull for all intents and purposes. Now, hold on. If you're not, you know, for those of you who are involved in mathematics and physics and all of that, this one might interest you. But we're saying that, look, rather than just having a space elevator, there's a plan for a moon elevator, which might be possible with the kind of technology which we have in, you know, a few years' time. But hey, it's still a fun idea. But the simple fact is that this tower will need to be so strong to support its own weight and that of a counterweight at the far end, which is that no known material or even a reasonably hypothetical one will do it, not by a long shot. So the space elevator has remained well on the fiction side of science fiction since its first proposal. Well, it hasn't stopped people from patenting it, though. It's possible. Anything can happen in the future. You might know some stories about some people who said some things were not possible. I mean, there was a time when having moving images behind your screen looked impossible. But hey, come on, we have it. You never know what could happen in 50 years' time. All right. Moving on from that. Now, Google says it's taking new steps to ensure that original reporting gets prioritized in its search results. In other words, articles that kick off a major news cycle should have a prominent place in search results for a longer time rather than getting buried under more recent coverage, which some of which may just summarize the original story. Now, while we typically show the latest and most comprehensive version of a story in news results, we've made changes to our products globally to highlight articles that we identify as significant original reporting. This was a quote from Google's Vice President of News, Richard Gingras, who wrote in a blog post. He continues to say that such articles may stay in a highly visible position longer. Now, this prominence allows users to view the original reporting while also looking at more recent articles alongside it. Prior to this time, SEO, which we know as search engine optimization, is something that has been quite big, you know, but what they're working on is relevant. So they're saying that no matter how much of work you put in SEO, in news that is not relevant, they're saying that the most relevant ones will show at the top of your search for news. Now, to a final story, originally announced in June, changes to Apple's App Store policies on its sign-in with Apple service and the rules around children's app categories are being tweaked. New apps must comply right away with the tweaked terms, but existing apps will have until early 2020 to comply with new rules. Now, the changes announced at Apple's developer conference in the summer were significant and raised concerns among developers that the rules could handicap the ability to do business in a universe that frankly offers tough alternatives to ad-based revenue for children's app. All right, that's all we can take this morning on our tech updates. Let's head over now. Titi has something for us.
Some really interesting stuff there, Mike, I have to say. I'm interested in that space elevator. But we have to go straight to music now. La Crown, formerly Oluwa Demilade Fayemi, is a hip-hop artist signed to Bottles Entertainment. Now, he has done some songs with Zlatan, Slim Case, Q Dot, so many other greats. And he's going to be performing one of his songs right now. And I'm just, I don't want to assume, but this song is called Off Lights. Yeah. Really? Off Lights?
Yeah, Off Light.
Off Light. Okay, so did I get the name right? La Crown, or is it LA Crown?
No, no, La Crown.
All right, so you want to tell us a bit about this song?
Oh yeah, I got featured by DJ Chrisland, and I had to do a song, Off Light.
Okay.
So you know what it means when you're off the light.
Okay. Okay, so I was assuming right.
I was asking the question in the song, like, who off the light, who off light?
Okay.
Because, you know, when you're in a party and you're having fun and all, and the light goes off, everybody gets angry. I'm like, who off light?
All right. No, Ala. All right. I'm already feeling your swag right now. I can't wait for you to start performing. Yeah. All right. La Crown with Off Light up next.
It's a beautiful Monday,
yes,
and
sir.
If you are still in bed, I want you to know that grab something, whatever it is that you
drink. When you say grab something,
you know there are some people.
You have to be careful.
You know there are some people who do a mix of alcohol and stuff early in the morning. Please don't do it.
Oh my gosh! Wow.
Don't
some
do
people
it.
Have
yeah.
really odd habits in the morning. We are just advising you to watch us. Let us be your odd habit, please. And if you're still sleepy, wake up! Please, wake up right now.
Yeah.
A very good morning to you. Now, you ought to know that you're really special, honestly. They're special to us. That's why we wake up at this time of the day every morning, just to be there for you.
Yeah, we have to start our day with you. And we love that, that you join us every single day. My name is Yomi Owokwe.
And I'm Titilayo Oyinson. Let's stream together, live stream with us. TVCentertainment.tv and of course on Facebook Live at TVC Connect.
Yeah, send in your comments across our social media platforms with the hashtag Wake Up Nigeria on TVC. That's you can use Twitter, Instagram, and of course Facebook as well.
Or even better, just download the app. What are you waiting for? It's available on both the Android and iOS stores. Please have this app very handy. Watch us from anywhere in the world.
Mm-hmm. And of course, we're also going to be welcoming our chef back into the kitchen this morning.
Very soon, in a few minutes,
as they're getting stuff ready.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the chef's going to be in the kitchen with Mary today.
Yes, so. And it's one of those days where you just need something special to make in the kitchen. Yes, you're trying to figure out a way to spice up your Monday meal, we might have something for you.
Yeah. Now we're going to be looking at some historical reminders for this week in history.
Yes, sir.
Mm.
You would not believe what happened this week in history.
Yeah.
You wouldn't believe.
But looking forward to it.
Then again, we also have some music coming to you live from our studios from the Houston native, Devin Kelly.
Still throwing stones at a glass house. They don't know what they talking about. You still a king, you a goddess. Just not clocking in for the nonsense. Imagine
for our Monday motivation today, Coach AAA will be giving us tips on how to start a winning day. I like that. That's a good thing for a Monday. And looking forward to his tips today.
Can't wait. And on our auto segment, have you been driving in the rain? Have you been driving properly in the rain? Well, Mr. Yomi Bosude, the mechanic of the big boys, let's just put it that way. He's going to be telling us what and what not to do when it comes to driving in the rain.
Our SME for this week, we're going to be having Alex Efeini of Nignum Design and Interior. It's a design firm in Lagos, and we're just going to be talking to him about some tips.
Yes, sir.
And how, of course, he started his business as well.
Alrighty, and if you're just waking up and you didn't hear in the first hour, MM has had her baby. Yes. Congratulations once again to
Congratulations
MM.
To MM, to the family as well.
MM.
Baby girl. And then congratulations to the other TVC staff here who had babies yesterday. There's a boy and a girl. There's Tosin and somebody else.
And Shegu.
Yeah, Tosin and Shegu.
You know, when they started saying the Shegu, everybody was like, wow, the guy gave birth.
So are they gonna get paternity leave? Maybe like 1 week, 2 weeks?
Wow,
like that.
Okay.
What should think of that?
I know the mothers get the standard 3 months, but...
But I think there was a time, it was Zuckerberg who took a paternity leave at one point where it really made the round, and some organizations actually do it.
Yeah, a few banks have started that in
some
Nigeria, but
it.
They
it's
usually,
never long.
So 1 week, 2 weeks. Yeah,
week or two.
I keep saying it. Maternity leave, paternity leave, that stuff is never enough. it took Lagos a while, it took the federal government a while, because Lagos started the whole 6 month thing.
Yeah.
And I think about, is it 3 weeks or a month paternity leave for guys? Mm. Then the mother gets 6 months. Mm. While federal now, as at last year, it became 4 months. Many people are not aware it's now 4 months. So I wonder what is happening to private organizations.
As the owner of a private organization,
you can't be letting someone go.
Look, as the owner of a private organization, when someone leaves, especially if they're a key important person, as they go, it's tough. Yeah, to replace them. If it's a small organization, maybe you guys are like 5 or 6.
Yeah.
A key person leaves, maybe you're an admin person.
Yeah.
It's tough. And then you can imagine you're paying that person for not working for three months, and then now you want to extend it to 4 or 5 or 6.
I like to think about it as paying that person to stay on your team.
Yes.
That's
the way I see it.
That's what
you're doing. You know what happened? This happened with it. There's this mobile network, major one, that at one point they actually let go some females.
Yeah.
And this was part on the line, between the lines. Mm. They were trying to avoid things like this.
Mm.
And even was it showing their recruitment policy.
Yeah, of course.
So they're trying to find ways to go around it.
Exactly.
Mm. Is she married? Mm. If she's married, okay, let's think about how old. If she's just newly married?
It started happening.
So they started avoiding this. Mm. They started avoiding. So I don't know. If you're a business owner, it can be challenging.
It's definitely challenging.
I feel
because like it just affects your plans.
Yeah,
So how do we? Okay, do I hire a temporary person for the 3 months, or do I hire someone and then this person is then suddenly ready to come back to work?
And then, what if I hire someone and then the person is better?
And I was talking to him about this, and he kept complaining and complaining and complaining. And I just asked him 2 questions. The first one, I said, at some point in time, your wife was also on maternity leave at our office.
You said
he was like, but I said, wait. Number two, this member of staff you're talking about is the person invaluable, like someone you really would like to come back to work with you.
Yeah.
He said, yes, but. And I said, then you don't even have to bother yourself.
Mm.
Look, sometimes temporary staff can become a permanent staff and could also be very important. So
what we need to do is just pray for growth of the whole company so that they can cover it at this point, because there's
no way to
solve this problem right now.
They don't know it. Chef, they already know. Put it. Just show them. No, point out. Yeah, but welcome to the kitchen this morning. And it's going to be quite a very, very different one. Someone already smiling. Your smiles are too wide. But there's a reason. This morning, we're doing something quite very interesting. I have Chef Julius. I have Chef Julius in the house with me this morning. And he's going to eat. The way Chef Julius is going, I can see very great things in his future. And for a very, very simple reason, Baba just decided to just scatter the place this morning. This is what's happening. We're cooking Edikaiko. Say it again.
Edikaiko.
Do you say like that?
Edikaiko.
Edikaiko. Yeah. Hey! Edikaiko soup this morning, right? And there's a lot we have to work with here this morning, which is the reason why a lot of people are smiling at me. Let's take a look at the menu. Ingredients this morning. Edika soup and pounded yam. Our ingredients, onions, pepper, red oil, dry fish, crayfish, cow skin, aka pomo, stockfish, water leaf, pumpkin leaf, and of course, pounded yam. But we have some other things here. I'm seeing like four or five different kinds of meat here. Which kind of meat? What's this one?
This is stockfish.
Ah, stockfish is looking like meat. I'm waiting for it today. Mm-hmm. And this is, which fish is this?
Catfish.
This is catfish, dry catfish.
Dry catfish.
Not point and key. This one has already been pointed and killed. Okay, and this is what?
Cow leg.
The conte. That's for insiders. We call it conte. All right, and then this is chicken. Oh, we might have chicken. That wasn't even part. This one is even extra safe. All right, and then the other things we have, I can see this is
pumpkin leaf.
Pumpkin leaf, what we call ugu.
Yes.
Right? Then water leaf. So, growing up, we used to have water leaf beds, garden in my house over. Oh. So, what happened was that for water leaves and ugu, we used to pluck it ourselves. So, whatever we cook was what we grew, which is quite cool. I think that's one way sustainable feeding of a nation all about when you can eat what you grow. That's something quite cool. We had popo and some other stuff. But yeah, this really brings back a lot of memories right here. Okay? So, this is one kitchen segment you don't want to miss because you don't know it. What's just gonna happen here? We'll take this break now, no going away. We will be right back with much more on the show. Oh. Yep, our next performer this morning is from Houston. She's from Houston, not just based in Houston. She's a songwriter who combines stunning melodies with infectious grooves and great beats. Now she's going to be performing one of her latest songs for us, Devin Kelly in the house. How you doing?
I'm doing very well.
Good, good. So we're having this performance first, and then we'll talk to you after this. Let's take go. It away.
You don't really want to let go. It's so hard not to live in the past. Look forward to victories ahead. You are the best, a dream come true.
It's happening, it's happening. Edika Ekong soup this morning and pounded yam. So a number of people on social media are like, it's not too heavy for breakfast. What we do here is not just only breakfast. Even though in this economy as it is, that kind of heavy breakfast is a necessity. But hey, come on. Well, don't just do only breakfast. Some you can take, you know. But what do you think about the Dikaikon for breakfast?
Well, it's a very good food.
Ah!
Fresh from the farm.
Myself and Chef Julius were on the same page. Very, very nice for breakfast. If bread and tea that is doing
and
you.
It's a very healthy food. Everything from the farm, very fresh.
Fresh food, any kind of call. Okay, let's get straight to it. So we've already diced, we've cut our leaves, right? Leaf. That's ugu leaf and that's water leaf, okay? Yeah. All right, so while there's water is boiling, okay?
Yes, I'm getting set for the...
All right, so...
Swallow.
Okay, this is the for... Soup. Ah, when you hear that sound, you know something is just happening. But we've already washed our fish, right?
Yeah.
And all of that. We're not using the head.
No.
Okay, but why are you not using the head?
Because of bone,
eh? Yeah. But then some people might prefer, they might want to use the head, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay, so let's take a look at our ingredients again. Once again for this, the ingredients now will just show on your screen and then we'll go over all of them, what we're doing for this morning, Edika Ekong soup and pounded yam. Mm. Of course, we have our water leaf, we have our ugu leaf, we have our cow leg. So my guys call it conte. I understand. And then we have pomo there. Like you can see, we have onions, we have pepper, we have red oil, crayfish, we have dry fish, we have cow skin, stockfish, water leaf, pumpkin leaves, and of course, the swallow is pounded yam. Okay, so this is our crayfish. What's this white stuff here that we can
see?
The pandu. Ah! Yeah. I mean, is this... Chef Julius?
Yes.
I go back to you. What's this?
This is pandu.
Is this for MM's baby or something? This is for a newborn baby now. Yomi, what the TT? What's this? Let me just hide it. This is not the swallow. You see? It tell me better. What's this one? There's no pandan jam. No, just this is just super dream. What's this? Is it baby that's eating here? Don't worry, just drop that one by the side. Don't bother about it. Okay. But let's see how do the stuff that we're doing, which one goes in first? How does it go?
The oil goes in first.
The oil goes in first,
Yeah.
Palm oil, right?
Yeah, palm oil.
Okay. So we have to make sure that what we have here is dry already.
Okay.
Okay, it's dry, right? Okay, all right, okay. So, yep, let's get the oil set and ready. Ah, Chef Jules, this guy, your head is dear. Your head is very correct. Ah, so the oil is going inside here?
The pot first.
Huh?
The oil.
The oil, eh?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey! Ah! Oh, man. Ah, are you seeing this? Chef, this one don't do.
Yeah, it's okay.
You sure say it don't do okay?
Yes.
Go and look at me, because me now, I'm okay.
It's okay.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Ah, nice one. See this oil that is just... You know some people that will just go and be frying oil in their place and you not think that meat is happening, but just oil frying. But this one, there's plenty happening. So while the oil is getting set, what else are we getting set here?
Yes. We'll be adding the stock.
The stockfish first, eh?
Yes.
That's the first thing that goes inside, eh?
Yes.
All right, is it going to be, it's packed. Are we going to break it up or something?
Yes, very.
Okay, so what are we using for that? Okay, let's see. Where's do we need a chopping board?
Yes.
Do we need a chopping board? Where's our chopping board?
Here.
Okay, ah, nice one, nice one. So we need it, right? Mm. Okay, let's make it happen, let's make it happen. Let's make it happen. How long should the palm oil?
As soon as this is ready now, put in inside.
Okay, so I'm just asking because of, I want you to know. It's not like I don't know. So for those of you out there that might be asking, and you say you're a Bamish, if I share for you here, you will know that. So I'm just asking so that you will know, not for me. Not for me, it's for you. It's for you. Okay, so while myself and Julius were getting this ready, this will go in first. We'll still come back and let it, okay, just see it going. Just let's round up with this one.
Okay.
Let's put in some of, aha, that's the first thing. Let us just hear the sound. Let us hear, it's okay. So, we're getting this set here, but then Devin Kelly performed earlier. She's now on the couch and we're going to have a sit down with her. We're going to be talking to her about her career and all of that. Mary's going to be doing that.
For a minute there, I was about to make for the door. Thought there was a fire starting. Anyway, you're welcome again. It's still Wake Up Nigeria, and it's time for us to have a conversation with Devin Kelly. Now, she's from Houston. She's a Houston-based singer and songwriter who combines stunning melodies with infectious grooves and great beats. Earlier, she performed one of her latest songs for us, and it was fantastic. So if you missed it, you want to do a rewind and watch it again. And you know, when I hear of Houston, great to have you here, by the
way. Thank you for having me.
The first person that comes to my mind is Beyoncé, because everyone knows she's from Houston.
Yes.
Tell me you're a Rockets fan.
I love the Rockets. Oh, and I love Beyoncé, too. Gotta give a shout-out to my big sis.
So, like, for me, the Rockets are, like, the biggest thing. Yeah, I've always loved the Rockets, yes. And I'm a big Harden fan. So that's great to know.
Yes, cool. The Rockets are on. Anything Houston, I love it. I love it.
Almost everyone who comes from Houston loves everything Houston. So are you originally from Houston, though?
I am originally from Houston. My origins are everywhere, but I'm from Houston.
When you say everywhere, what do you mean?
Oh, my goodness. So I'm Creole. I would be considered Creole, but okay. My Creole origins are Wales, France, Cameroon, Nigerian, and probably a few other things.
Okay, so I'm looking to see how come you have a fair skin, because I'm like a combination of different colors. I would have expected something purple. Your mom is from, is she also American?
My mom is American, but she's the one that's mixed with Nigerian, Cameroon, and French.
Okay. Yeah. While your dad is from Houston,
yes,
right?
Yes, my dad's from Houston.
Fantastic. So music, you've been doing music since you were about, 12?
Yeah, I've been doing music since I was about 12. I started writing my own songs in school, just in class, or in choir rehearsal at church, and from there I was just like, this is what I need to do.
Now, so you started with the gospel angle.
Yes.
Before you went into what we call the mainstream music.
Yes, yeah. I had to sing in church every single Sunday. Like, I had no choice.
Wow.
Like, I would literally be praying and they would be playing my song and I'd be like, oh Lord, I'm about to have to sing. Like, every Sunday.
All right, so I know for you, music is a big deal.
Yes.
Music is a big deal. So far, so good. What has the music industry been like for you, like, ever since you started? Because I know in the US, you aren't doing badly for yourself there. So what has it been like, especially doing music in America? The market there is very competitive.
I mean, it's been amazing because you have an opportunity to find yourself, find your lane, find the people that love you, find the music that you like. So that's been the greatest joy to me. It's just like creating my own lane and also monetizing off of it. It's pretty nice.
Now, you're in Nigeria now, and the question is, for someone who is doing so well in the US, what are you doing in Nigeria? I'm sure so many people are wondering.
I love Nigeria.
You love,
like,
Nigeria?
I grew up being in a singing group with a Nigerian girl, so I grew up like kind of living in a Nigerian household with them, like when we would rehearse for our performances. And you know, Houston is Nigeria. Like, there's so many like legit Nigerians there, so you can actually get the entire culture in Houston.
Wow.
Southwest Houston is there.
Okay, so you know what we're going to do before we continue our conversation? Let's take a look at one of Devin Kelly's music videos. Like a star, got up stunned. Like a star, got up stunned. Like a star, you can go bigger. Now, I know you write as well.
Yes.
So if you weren't doing music, you'd be doing what?
I think I would probably be a writer, just writing books, you know, writing about self-help. I love to be analytical and to dig in things and create stories and ideas. So
I would likely be a writer.
I would be a writer, probably.
But you also wrote the lyrics to that song.
I did.
What motivated it? Because it's more like an encouragement song, like inspiring stuff.
That's my favorite question, because I really want everybody to know that whatever you do, whatever lane you are in, you can be a star. And that's why I called it like a star, because I want people to listen to it and whatever they're doing, if they're cooking and they're cleaning, even if they're messing up, and I want them to know that they can feel like a star too. So
now let's imagine you could do music with any Nigerian artist. Who would you pick? Okay, let's make it two.
Okay. First, for sure, it would be Tiwa Savage. Like, I probably wouldn't be sitting here on this couch if it weren't for her. And Tenny, because I mean, I ran into Tenny yesterday and I was like, oh my gosh, please take me on tour. Let's do a song together, girl, please. And Tenny is gorgeous, by the way. Her skin is like flawless.
Now, you said you wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Tiwa Savage. What do you mean by that?
Well, because I studied music and Tiwa Savage studied music. So when I heard her songs, I fell in love with her style of Afrobeat. But then when I found out she went to Berklee College of Music, that really inspired me, because I grew up going to school for music and studying music. So I was like, wow, like, I can really do whatever I want to do, you know?
So she's an inspiration to you.
She is.
Internationally, who would you like to do music with?
Wow. Definitely Tenny and Tiwa. I would love, maybe I could have a song of both of them.
Okay.
But yeah, like Tenny and Tiwa. Of course, like maybe like Rihanna, of course.
Rihanna. Yeah. Not even your Eastern girl?
With Beyonce, like, I feel like that's something that she would have to decide. Like, she's like, yeah, I don't want to be thirsty and just put out there. That's something that Beyonce would have to decide. But hopefully when she's in the mood, she chooses your girl.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for
having
me.
Thank you so much. Devin Kelly right there. Of course, we hope to hear more from you and, of course, more of your music. The second R is just about over. We'll take this break, and of course the third hour continues shortly. Stay with us. Now, the best way to start your week is with a dose of the Wake Up Nigeria medicine.
Yeah, do some good to, you know, and you. I mean, this is a good way to start your day, because everything that you get on the show, especially on the Monday, just sets the tone for your week.
Yes, indeed. Now, a very good morning to you once again. Thank you so much for being there. We really appreciate it, like, really. Thank you so much.
You know what they call crocodile tears.
Yeah, but that's we love you. You know we do. My name is Titi Laya Oyinsan.
I'm Yomi Ope. We're streaming live right now. Don't forget, that's as usual. So that's at tvcentertainment.tv.
Yes, sir.
And of course on Facebook as well. Check us out at TVC Connect. We're also streaming live on Facebook as well.
So far, the comments have been so nice about my hair. I have to ask for more. Please send in some comments. Use our hashtag
Wake Up Nigeria on TVC. And of course, that our app is on fire right now, really. We have an app you can download.
And yeah, you can download it right now, of course, and watch us from anywhere in the world. iOS, Android, we're on it. Just search for it using TVC Connect on the App Store.
Mr. Yomi Bosude is going to be in the building soon. He's going to be giving tips on how best to drive in the rains, especially if there's flooding in your area.
Now, every Monday, we bring you inspiring stories from owners of businesses. And we have that SME segment today. And looking forward to meeting Alex Efeini of Nignum Design and Interior Design Firm in Lagos.
Indeed. And it's really interesting. You know, we've actually been having a segment called, you know, the home makeover segment. And it's interesting what goes into this work that Lignum Design does.
Yeah.
There's a lot of thought. There's a huge thought process that goes into it. I was just thinking about, so when I was a lot younger, I was living in the staff quarters of where I used to work.
Yeah.
And so with that whole DIY mentality, I went out to buy paint and I started painting the wall myself. So the other members of the house were like, ah, what's doing this wall? Is she that cheap? And I'm like,
you're just a DIY person.
No, if you're abroad, do you know how much
people don't know
how much a painter costs abroad? Like, dude, it's just a roller with some paint.
Yeah, can it's not that simple.
So a handyman comes to check your switches.
Yeah.
A handyman comes.
Okay.
And when he's leaving, he's already charging like $50 or £50, as
it's
the case
crazy.
May be. And you're like,
of course.
Just to check if this thing is working. You will learn to do this thing.
I paint. It took me about 3 days.
So that was my dad. That was my dad. Like, he had this box.
Yeah? Okay.
You call it his toolbox.
Okay.
Hammers, pinchers, nails, everything. So when I was little thing around the house, that's how we grew up.
Mm.
Painting, some other stuff.
We don't
do it, man. Yeah. There's no big deal. Yeah. It can't be cheap. So what is worrying you? So can I paint my I'm putting my wallpaper or something.
So I when you're like when you're doing the rolling and everything, the paint will stain you.
Yeah.
They will not come, they'll not laugh at me. I see this one. Like as I used to feel really odd.
Yeah.
Me 3 days, but I painted my entire room.
Wait, and one room?
Yeah, it was one room now. Ah, see,
wait,
I
no,
the
no,
one
you
room.
Said 3 days. That's what I was wondering.
3 days, yeah, because I had to climb up, I had to paint the ceiling.
I think, yeah,
I had to do
the ceiling.
Well done. I think it was a great job. You know, speaking of which, over the weekend, a hammerhead shark.
Got hammered, literally.
Well turned up on the beach in.
Oh, wow.
Ibejuleki.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course it died.
Yeah,
and
but that's really real.
It was huge, like a proper hammerhead shark. Yeah.
No way.
I saw the pictures.
So you know it's not really safe to swim in Nigerian waters, but a lot of people do. And if a hammerhead shark got that close, imagine
really
what
safe.
Other...
I don't think it's safe for us to continue this conversation. We need to head straight to the news. I know.
Welcome back. Guess what? Are you aware that you can have a winning day today if you start it and also exude the right attitude? Now, Coach AAA will be shedding some light on this in a minute. And Alex Adeadefemi, AAA, is a peak performance coach and the lead coach of the Alex Adeadefemi Advisory. And of course, he's joining us this Monday talking about starting your day right, which is very, very key because it can even, on a Monday like this, it can even affect the rest of your week.
Tell me about it.
So, I know this is Lagos, many challenges that people go through
Lord.
From sun up to sundown.
Crazy.
But how do you start your way right?
First of all, you need to start you by looking good like you did. You do. Your tie, your suit, all packaged, looking good. You need to start your day that way.
I'm packaged. Right. Okay.
But seriously now, good morning. Now, if you want to start your day, now it's, like you said, this is Lagos. So basically, if you live in a busy state or city like Lagos, you need to be able, there are some things that you need to bear in mind. if you are going to go out on a Monday morning, Tuesday, even whatever day of the week. There are some things that I found out that helps you actually be able to be productive, perform at your peak. Now, that's the key word here, performing at your peak. Because you look at it, you look at, I use an example, let me say football. You find a player like Ronaldo, who tends to always be able to perform at his peak. There is a routine to it, and it's found that there's a routine to it. I also found out that people like the best keeper at some time was Manuel Neuer of Germany. He had a routine. So there's a routine that you should have if you want to perform at your peak every morning. And I think for me, I'll advise the first thing you start with is you start with being able to pray and meditate. Now, I know that a lot of us in this country are religious, we are spiritual people, so and that's very key. So, but I added to another word to it, there's meditation in it. Meditation is simply just sitting down and for a few minutes just brooding on how you want your day to look like. So you have prayed, then you just sit down for like 5 minutes. It doesn't have to take too long. About 5 minutes and just picture your day, what you want to see happen in your day.
You know, it's easy for you to say these things. There are certain people who live in Ikpaja or the deep areas, Ikorodu, and they work on the island, they work in Lekki. And so sometimes your commute is up to 2 hours.
Yes.
Sometimes 2 hours, 30 minutes, almost 3 hours every single day. So you wake up at four, you're on the go. So sometimes all this meditation that you're saying, you know, it won't work because
I totally understand.
Wake up 2 seconds later, I'm in the bathroom.
You know, I get it. I'm a Nigerian, I live in Lagos. I was working before I started running my own business. So I understand.
So how do I get that time to do that meditation?
Now, all I'm asking you for is 15 minutes.
It's too expensive.
Wait, hear me out. You know, I said it's 15 minutes.
Yep.
When you wake up as early, and some of the people, they wake up at 4 a.m.
Yep.
But trust me, if you don't have 10 to 15 minutes for yourself, you don't have a life. You are in slavery, literally. You should be able to find at least 10 minutes for your life. Because at the end of the day, it's all about you. If you don't perform well at work, you might still get fired. So you might as well just, if you take these 10 minutes out, and you are able to be produce, and it can help you improve your productivity for the remainder of maybe, say, 15 hours of the day, then I think it's not a bad investment. So it's an investment in yourself for the first 10 minutes in the morning. First thing you do is, I'll advise, of course, I expect that you wake up early.
Now, so you're insisting that everyone carve out that 10 minutes
as much
as possible.
I insist. There's no way. Listen, what's going to happen at the end of the day is that you're going to probably just go through the day. You will not perform at your peak. Remember, I said it's about performing at your peak. It's not just about doing enough. It's about getting the best out of yourself on a daily basis so that people who you're working with, people who you are relating with, can get the best of you. And they can also say, oh, this person is always performing and always delivering.
All right, so let's go to the next thing now. So I've woken up.
So the first thing is, and the truth of the matter is, most people, as religious as we are, most people still pray in the morning now.
Of course.
They pray.
Okay, so I've woken up, I've prayed, I've meditated.
So all those prayers and meditation I'm saying is like 5 minutes I'm asking for.
Yeah.
So just do 5 minutes prayer and meditation. When you're done with that, the next thing you need to do is you need to try and move your body.
Right.
Now, so people wake up in the morning a lot of times and they just wake up and get up and they get into the bathroom. And that has an effect on your physiology and eventually an effect on your psychology. Because your body feels, you know, literally what people do is they drag their bodies through the day. But a simple move, exercise, motion. Now, I'm not talking about just getting up and going to bed. So you get up, you first of all stretch. Stretch for like a minute. Stretch your back, stretch everywhere. Stretch your hands, stretch your legs. That stretch has a way of releasing tension. Releasing the, what's it called, that you've been sleeping with.
Yeah.
You know, you've been sleeping for a while. But if you drag yourself, most people, they just get up, they drag themselves to the bathroom and just put on the shower.
Yeah.
And then expect the shower to be the one to actually reinvigorate them. Yes, the shower does that, but it's easier, first of all, if you stretch. After you stretch, the next thing I'll advise you to do after stretching is move your body exercise. So there are simple things you could do. It's something I do in the morning. I just raise my hands up and do this and breathe in and out. So let me just show you.
Yeah.
What that does is that it gets blood flowing.
Right, right.
So I'm not asking you to do jog in the morning. You probably can't, maybe because you're working somewhere, yeah, or you have to rush, take the kids to school and all that stuff. So you can't do that.
This 10 minutes meditation, you're asking me to add exercise?
Yes, I'm asking you. So 5 minutes, and this other minute I'm asking you for is another like 3 to 5 minutes, and that's about 10 minutes.
That's added to it, though.
Yes.
Traffic is building, at the bus stop, things are happening.
I know, trust me.
It's becoming tighter.
Trust me, that 10 minutes will not change the course of traffic. Trust me, I guarantee you. What you just need to do, just that, because a lot of times what we do is that you find out, if you check, unless we're not being honest, check most people, in the morning, they still do one or two things that drags their morning, that 10 minutes that I'm asking for, they use it for other things that in the morning. Mm. So another thing I would suggest is, if you can, first of all, you need to drink water. Drink, at least get a glass of water into your system.
Into your system.
That one does not take more than 5 seconds. Yeah. Take a glass of water. I would love if you could have breakfast. But if you can't have it there, you could have it at the office. A cup of tea and one or two slices of bread. It's fine. Mm. Or maybe even a biscuit. It's fine. Just to put some energy in your body so you can start your day effectively. Mm. And the next thing is when you get to the office, if you can't do it at home, when you get to the office, before you start anything, identify the most pivotal things that you must do today that would have the most effect on your productivity on that day. Mm. So for you to be able to achieve results, you must identify. The reason why I focus so much on the physical part of things is because we don't pay attention to it, and it has an adverse effect on how the day goes all through. So if you are dragging, imagine you're dragging yourself through the day, and then what happens is that you're on the road, there's traffic, and then somebody does something to you, even if you are trying to be civil, you're already tense.
Yeah.
So, but even by the time you get to work, you realize that you're not. You literally have to start telling yourself, "I need to bring up my A game." Mm. But it's difficult. But I guarantee you, and I say it to you, try this. And if you don't, it doesn't work. Come, send me a message and say, "AAA, it was a hoax. It didn't work."
And then he'll give you back your money. Thank you so much for joining us on the show today.
Thanks.
Hopefully, you've learned a thing or two. Let's try that out today. If you're still at home at this time, you're one of the blessed ones. So let's try this for this week and see what happens. And then we'll give you some feedback. He's going to be with us again on Monday. Heading over to the garden now, where Mary is on standby with Yomi Busude for the auto segment.
Quite a descriptive conversation that has been. Well, you're welcome to the garden, and it's time for the auto segment of the show. Today, as usual, we have Yomi Busude. Great to have you here today.
Hello, Mary.
Fantastic. Good morning. Good morning. Now, our focus today is on tips on driving in the rain. And I'm sure you have great ones for us. So let's get started. What's the very first you need to know?
First, you need to reduce your speed.
Okay.
Because when it rains, you know, the pavement is very, or the roads and pavements are really slippery.
Sneak,
so you don't have to go at that your usual 100, 120, whatever you do.
So what would you recommend?
You reduce it to about a third of it.
Okay.
Because first, visibility is poor.
Okay.
Good. So once you understand your visibility level, because I mean, a lot of people don't even see properly when it's not raining.
Talk less of when it's raining.
You understand. There's also precipitation.
Okay.
Now that's a lot. Okay. What's precipitation? When you have fog or mist on your windshield, front and rear.
Okay.
So you also need to understand how to deal with that when it rains.
Okay.
Now it's worse when your car's AC is not working.
Okay.
Because when it's working, it's easy for the cool air to disperse the precipitated air.
Making it easier to wipe it.
Yes, to even clear it off.
Mm.
So also on your AC, HVAC or your AC system, there's a way you can set it, position the controls, so that also helps with the clearing the front mist. Apart from having good wipers too. Your wipers are very important. Now this wiper here is still very good and intact, but if it was bad, it would probably be slightly ripped off. But in this case, you have the wipers
in good condition.
So it's something I'll advise that we all get to check now.
Okay.
Check your wipers that they're in place before you get caught up in the rain. So once, and check both of them, because you've got two wipers. Some cars have just one, the uni wiper kind of vehicle. So check it before, now that the rains are back. So you need to have that properly done.
So what else do we need to know?
You also need to check your windshield reservoir.
Okay.
Now it's usually in the vehicle here. You can hang this up here this way. Now, it usually has a blue cover over here, and it says what?
Washer only.
Washer only.
Oh.
Yes, this is where you put water in that comes out when you press a certain button and splashes
everything
on your windshield. Yes.
Know, affecting poor pedestrians, but that's all right. Let's go.
No, that's when it's not set properly.
Okay.
If you don't.
Also, people need to set it properly.
If it has been damaged or something has gone wrong with it.
It goes everywhere.
It now goes everywhere.
Because I see ideally, that happen a lot.
No. Ideally, it's meant for your windshield only.
Okay. So
by the time you press the button, it hits somewhere around here, and your wipers help to clear your windshield.
Because some people actually do that. It's everywhere. Pedestrians are screaming, Oga, calm down.
That's when it's defective. It now goes everywhere because it's not meant for every people on the pedestrians around. It's meant for your windshield.
Okay. You know,
so that comes into play as well.
Okay.
And also another important thing is not to run into stagnant water. Especially in the middle of the road.
Okay.
That means there's a hole there. So it's a pothole that's been filled with water.
So be very careful when
you're going into puddles. Be very careful. Go in gently. Even if you don't have any other means of getting away, go in gently. And don't go in with both tires. Go with just one tire at a time.
I feel like this is something that we might not be able to finish handling today. So we need to get moving with the show. Thank you so much, Yomi Bosu. Fantastic conversation. Wake Up Nigeria continues right after this break. Stay with us.
Now, every Monday, we feature an SME or growing business right here on the show. And they usually tell us a story of how they started and, of course, how they are surviving in an economy like Nigeria's. Now, Alex Ifeanyi is the CEO of Lignum Design, a firm committed to designing with excellence and a strong focus on space, functionality and sustainability. Now, Lignum prides itself on combining architecture and interior exterior design to find unique and aesthetically pleasing solutions. And Alex is joining us this morning. Good to have you here on the show.
Thank you.
Looking ready for the Monday. Now,
thank you.
You know, I always talk to CEOs and founders of different companies. Right. And usually one thing that everybody wants to know is how you started this vision, how it came to pass, how you decided that, look, I'm going to be an entrepreneur. This is what I want to do.
Well, for me, it was quite straightforward. Why? Because I came from a family where we are art inclined. And, you know, creativity has always been the bane of our growing up, if you get what I mean. So I started off as an event planner, an event designer. And it got to a point where I felt I could actually do much more. I wasn't satisfied, you know, with the limitations in that space. I wanted to do more. I wanted to create long-lasting spaces as against, you know, you setting up a space for an event and then tearing it down after a while. You know, I wanted spaces that would, you know, stay for a longer time. You know, you're driving past and then you see, oh, nice space, you know. So I actually loved the architectural look and feel of structures.
One of the things that you talked about in your profile is design excellence.
Exactly.
I know that 20, 25 years ago, maybe even 10 years ago, anybody that was thinking of setting up an executive office, you think about flying in furniture from Dubai, South Africa especially. I know a lot of stuff coming from South Africa, a number of international countries as well. Very expensive, some of them going as high as $50,000 and things for couches and tables and things like that. But you are introducing Nigerian excellence in furniture and interior and things like that. How have you been able to introduce that specifically into the Nigerian space and also command the attention of high-profile clients?
Okay, so basically, we're more than just a design company. So we just only don't plan spaces or design spaces. We also create and design elements for that spaces because the interior design industry is a very technical one. And we are always very detailed. So take, for example, we have a space We need to know the size of the space and what kind of elements will fit in that space. For us, functionality is key, safety is key, durability, and you know, all of these things are very important when it comes to designing. We have grown in Nigeria immensely in terms of having artisans and people in furniture making who actually can interpret our designs and bring these designs to excellence. The world is fast moving, and we've also been trying to also combine innovation and technology into every of our designs as well. So
it's one of the things that when you mention artisans now, it's one of the things that I know is a big challenge for for entrepreneurs, whether you're a tailor or, you know, the artisans are a big deal. And so how do you ensure that you work with the right guys and also work with them consistently? Because artisans, you know, in Nigeria, you know how they are. you get a guy who can do a great job, but he's not consistent or he's not available, he's not picking his calls. How do you ensure that you have the right guys working with you and they consistently come up with consistent designs that are high quality?
Okay, so like we all know, you know, human capacity is very, very important. We have people who are really talented, but they tend to lack certain key characteristics in terms of, you know, being on time, important to deliverables, professionalism and stuff like that. So over the time, yes, that is a major challenge in Nigeria as a whole. However, you know, when you start, you find those who are good, you try to keep them, and keeping them is a lot of work because you need to not only build some level of confidence in them, but make them always happy and comfortable every time, and inspired as well to always want to get the job done. So for me, I would say, you know, how you go about managing the great talents you have around you is key in trying to build a team from time to time. However, that isn't to say we don't have difficult artisans and those who obviously would mess up you know your job. But of course, over the time, yes, we've had such experiences, and we've had to do it over again, you know.
So let's talk about how a growing business or an SME begins to scale up the operations. So your target market, obviously, when you start a big design firm is, you know, get the people that will pay for high quality stuff. But are you thinking about expanding, going into the mass market, start making things like products that people can buy off the shelves and things like that? Is that part of your business model?
Yeah, that's more in the long term.
Yeah.
Right now we're trying to focus more on our designs and of course planning of spaces.
So you're expensive, in other words.
No, we're not. we're really affordable. Trust me. However, we also are looking to having most of our designs customized. And we can also, you know, export our own designs out of Nigeria as well.
Really key, because I mean, one of the things that I know happens with us is, you know, we start something and then we then discover that maybe there's not enough support. Do you get enough support for the business as an industry?
Now, when you talk about support, do you mean support?
Government support, institutional support from either banks, the international organizations.
Okay, so most of the things we do, we don't get support from the government or from the bank. However, it's a general challenge I think every entrepreneur actually go through in Nigeria. You know, we have so many things that are not functional. Take for example, power. It's massive.
Yeah.
And it affects, you know, our work as well. Good roads, you know, trying to move from point A to point B to deliver. Sometimes you have maybe two ongoing projects or three ongoing projects, and, you know, time is of essence. You know, you want certain things to be delivered in quick succession. And when you have bad roads, I mean, it's either the vehicle isn't getting to its destination early enough or there's a setback. And of course, law and order. You know, so we have quite a number of challenges which we go through. However, it's always very important that we constantly find solutions to solving these problems without necessarily waiting for the government to fix some of these things for us.
Alex, thank you so much for joining us on the show today. I'm going to be taking you to the kitchen. Something special is happening there. I don't know. You look very like a very slim guy. So you probably don't eat much or eat heavy in the morning, but we're going to make things a little bit different for you this morning. So join us in the kitchen there's action taking place already.
This is not heavy, this is optimal.
It's optimal.
Yes, welcome. It's optimal.
Welcome. So we have some pound o' yam for you then. Mm-hmm.
Right.
So this is not heavy, this is actually optimal. Okay. But it's something that can energize you for the rest of the day. Like Triple A said, you take this one and you are ready for the day. Okay, so we have Chef Jules, Chef Julius. Chef Julius, can you tell us what we put together?
This is edikaikron. And the ingredients are oil, red oil, pepper, fish, cow leg, stockfish, and chicken, and the pando itself.
Okay, you look very international.
I'm already celebrating.
Okay. Ah, you are. I want to try it. Eh?
So just have a taste of this.
Try it out. All right, fantastic.
And let's see how it goes.
Easy. Okay, so as in everybody's like. The whole office has
maybe
been
maybe it's very gentle. I don't know what it is. Why today. Is it so...
No, I right. just want to observe.
You want to observe?
I've been observing since the beginning of today now.
All right. You guys don't like this gentle.
Just try it. Start from anywhere.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. So, our chef today has been hard at work.
You could not see me. Your
Mike has been over his shoulder.
Over his... Those things I was turning. Titi, now I know.
I saw you mixing the soup.
Come on now. I was the one that did the main
job. And over-tasting it. I've never seen a chef that would be tasting in large bites.
So,
I like
when you like
say,
it?
Mike, when you say taste, it's taste.
I was tasting now.
You were packing.
No, I was tasting.
You were shoveling the food in your mouth.
Yeah, I want to say something.
I like the, you have stockfish in it.
Yeah.
I like the pepper in it.
Okay.
And then I honestly don't know what ingredients you have inside of it, but you know, it seems to have some very, you know, rich traditional flavor, which is good.
That's always the thing.
Rich. Nice. Yeah. And then on top of it, I like the pepper. I like pepper, so yeah, that works for me. This is actually good.
Yes, thank you.
Edikaikron on a Monday.
Thank you, Yomi.
Wow. Monday the right way.
What?
And our chef has brought it. The chefs coming for the next few days have to also bring it.
Yeah. The chef. Mike is here.
Yeah. Wow. Mike, well done.
What?
No, I haven't.
But it's been an amazing show so far. And we're just getting started.
Yeah, big thank you to our friends at Homely NG for the kitchen accessories.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. And of course, to all our guests, friends, followers, all of you who follow us each and every day, we really appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, we're going to be back tomorrow, as usual. 6 a.m. is the time.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. 6 a.m. bright and early. Right here on TVC.
Have a nice day.
Bye. Bye.